I'm sorry, Bill, but I'm leaving. And nothing you say can stop me. Do you hear me? Nothing.
Are you happy?
Oh, I'm happy.
Good. I'm happy.
Hi, Happy. I'm horny.
Excuse me?
So, what brings you here tonight?
I always go for group activity.
Really? What do you say we get together and make our own private little group tomorrow night?
Oh, I'd love to, but tomorrow's my aerobics for lovers class.
Do tell. How about Thursday?
Another class. How to make love to a real man.
Oh, my God, don't skip that. Not on my account. Well, how about the night after?
Oh, no. That's my acting out your sexual fantasies improv group.
Look, here. There's an empty hour.
You're right. A whole hour I can give just to you. It's a date. But don't you be mad at me if I'm just a little bit late.
Don't be late. I need that whole hour.
I'll try, Danny. But I have a date just before you with my parole officer.
You're a parole officer?
Oh, I have a teensy problem with rejection.
Oh, my goodness, who could reject you?
My last boyfriend. It really upset me. It also upset my teensy little pistol.
Oh, you didn't.
It was only a flesh wound. But that won't happen to us, will it, Danny?
No, of course not. Oh! What was I thinking? I'm gay.
At that exact moment, I have never felt more alone.
I felt abandoned like an orphan, didn't you, Spring?
Yes, Christine, that's it exactly. Abandoned. An orphan.
Oh, you must be the strippers.
Oh, sorry. We don't do these kind of parties.
Ready? And step, bump, step, bump, step, bump, step, bump, and rotate like an axle of a car. Round and round. Nadine, a sexy car.
Come over.
Hi, I'm Miriam. I'm officiating at your wedding. Are you kids ready? All right, the bride and the groom stand here, and the best man and the maid of honor at their sides.
Gilbert!
Dearly beloved.
How did you two meet?
Go ahead, George. Tell her, if you've got the guts. Tell them all.
Why, no, Martha, and deprive them the soft purr of your little voice.
Was it while fighting over the scraps of dead carcass?
Hardly. He wanted to impress the king of all hairy hominids, or, as I call him, Daddy. So he married his daughter.
A task both simple and Herculean.
But he was a big fat flop at being a savage beast. He couldn't frighten a titmouse.
Oh!
down there?
Trying to kill myself.
Oh. You need any help?
No. I can do it myself.
Are you sure? I don't mind.
No!